Now we will learn how to receive advance payments from customers using the sale receipt method. What happens when we make a sale receipt when a customer gives us a deposit in advance for work to be done in the future? Well, the trial balance will show a liability account for money that is owed to all customers for advance payments and deposits that we have not yet applied to invoices. This is because if a customer pays us in advance, technically we owe them that money until we do the job and put their deposit on an invoice. So if we owe them the money, that money should be listed as a liability on the trial balance. Unfortunately, if you use this method, there is no indication on the open invoice report or the customer balance detail that money is owed to a particular customer for advance deposit payment. So your trial balance will be accurate and it will show the total that you owe to all customers for deposits received where work was not yet done. But if you look at the specific customer's records, you will not be able to determine if any money is owed to them for an advanced payment. So that's the downside to this particular method. You must set up your file to use this method. With the previous method, you could record the transaction right away. But if you use this method before you start recording deposits, first, you have to create an account in the chart of accounts to represent the total money that we owe to all customers for advanced payment deposits. After you do that, you have to create an item in the items list to put on a receipt. When the customer pays in advance, we make a receipt and we put that item on the receipt. So you only have to set it up once. Put one account, put one item, then you can start making receipts and giving customers receipts for the deposits that they give you. We will set up our file as follows. We will make an account in the chart of accounts called Unused Customer Deposits. Then we will make an item on the items list called Customer Deposit Paid. Then we will be ready to record the transaction. From the main menu, we click List Chart of Accounts. In the bottom left, we click Account New. When the new account window opens up, we go down to this pull-down menu and choose Other Current Liability. Notice when we choose that account type, it gives us a description in the right panel. You can see that one of the reasons we would choose Other Current Liability is for security deposits or retainers from customers. This proves that this is the correct account type to use. Click Continue, and notice that account type is chosen right here on top. When we click for the name will be Unused Customer Deposits. Unused Customer Deposits. Now when we click Save and Close, we now have a new liability account in our chart of accounts. Now we have to put the item on the items list. From the main menu, click List, Item List. In the bottom left, click Item, New. The type of item in this case is Other Charge. And the name of the item, as we agreed, would be Customer Deposits Paid. So we type into the name field, Customer Deposits Paid. Okay. The account that's connected to this is the liability account that we just made, Unused Customer Deposits. This way, when we put this item on a receipt that we give a customer for a payment in advance, this account in the chart of accounts will go up and show on the trial balance. We click OK to save the item. We close the item window, and now we're set up and ready to record our first receipt where we give a customer a receipt for an advance deposit payment. February 27, we received $1,000 cash from Alan as a deposit for a future video job. Let's take a look how to record this under the new method. From the main menu, click Customers, enter Sales Receipt. Of course, I always like to collapse the ribbon if I'm not using it. Now, the customer is Alan. The date was February 27th. The method was cash. And of course, the item, oh, by the way, this is not going to be deposited directly to the bank account. Let's be clear. This is going to be deposited into undeposited funds. Alan gave us cash. The cash has to be physically brought to the bank later. That's just a little review of a previous video. But the most important thing about this receipt is that the item that we choose is this item, Customer Deposits Paid. And we put only the amount. Don't put anything in the quantity field. Don't put anything in the rate field. Just put the physical amount of cash that the customer gave. Put it in the amount field and push tab. Now we have a sale receipt that we can print and give to Alan. If we make this column longer, Alan can see that he's getting a receipt for a customer deposit paid. When we click Save and Close, we can open the trial balance, and the trial balance will show that we actually have a liability now. The company owes customers, it doesn't say which ones, but the company owes customers $1,000 for prepayments, payments in advance for work that will be done in the future. Now, February 28, Holden did 10 video hours for Alan and applied his deposit to the invoice that he made for that job. Let's take a look at how to record this. We open the invoice window and we put the information in. We put February 28, we choose the customer Alan, the quantity was 10, the item was video, and of course the total that Alan would owe is $3,000. However, because Alan gave us a deposit before, we will choose that item, Customer's Deposit Paid, and we will come to the amount field on the row of this item, Customer Deposit Paid, and we will put minus $1,000. That's because this invoice will decrease by $1,000 from Alan's previous deposit. When we push the tab key, we now have an invoice that we can give to Alan, and the invoice clearly says customer deposit paid as decreasing. In fact, if you want to put in the description the actual date that he gave the deposit or any other information about the deposit, that might give your customer confidence that they're being billed correctly. When we click Save and Close, don't worry about the spelling. We notice that the unused customer deposits is now zero. We now owe zero money to customers for any deposits they gave because we did the job and we applied it to an invoice.